donkey of the day right there.
The Breakfast Club, bitches.
You can call me the donkey of the day, but like, I mean no harm.
Donkey of the day for Wednesday, June 30th. Mike Tyson's born day. Cancer gang gang. Drop on the clues bombs for Mike Tyson, damn it. It's going to a nurse in North Carolina named Kelly Morris. Now, Kelly is a nurse at the Citadel Winston-Salem Nursing Facility, and she has been suspended from her job. Would you like to know what she was suspended for? Let's go to WXII NBC 12 for the report, please.
Kelly Morris worked as a nurse at the Citadel Winston-Salem Nursing Facility on First Street. She also has an active TikTok account where she goes by the username Bubblegum Kells and often includes content about her job that some say is way out of line. Several of you contacted WXII 12 this weekend expressing concern over videos like these that appeared to show Morris joking about mistreating her patients. Morris says they're just jokes, but she's been suspended by her employer and now has created a GoFundMe page entitled TikTok Got Me Fired, So Feed My Kids. As of this afternoon, the page has raised $55. After speaking with an attorney, Morris opted not to sit down with us for an interview, but in a statement to WXII 12 News, Morris says, quote, "The only thing hurt in my TikTok videos were people's feelings. All my videos are comedy skits. I can understand how someone can be upset, but not to the degree they are taking it. No one was ever harmed, and I treat all my patients with great care, and they all love me."
And Morris told me that to her, this is just another example of cancel culture. It says she feels she's being targeted by a campaign of people who just can't take a joke.
Okay, let's talk. The smartphone is the biggest stage in the world. It's the biggest stage ever. Okay, I told you all on this radio for weeks, walking around with this thing in your hand, this thing in your pocket, this device that gives you access to platforms like YouTube, Twitter, TikTok, Instagram, Facebook. It makes you feel like everything is content. It makes you feel like you want to perform. I applaud people who don't get caught up in the performance of it all, the performance of life. I'm telling you, it's a lost art, okay, just to be cool. People can't even focus on what God put them here to do because they are too busy wanting to perform for the world. Everybody wants to be a talent. Everybody wants to be a star. They think because they have an audience, no matter how big or how small, the audience is there and they have to entertain said audience. This is a nurse, okay, in a nursing facility doing comedy sketches. Okay, doing comedy sketches. Like, people are just sitting around waiting on the Nurse Kelly show. Now, I'm just using Kelly Morris as an example because she's donkey of the day today, but this is an example of how America is obsessed with celebrity on all levels, okay? A lot of Americans only equate real success with some form of celebrity, and let me be the first to tell you, that's stupid and sad. Okay, success is subjective. A nurse in North Carolina making a decent salary. You got a place to stay. You got food on the table. You got a car to drive. If you're happy with that, that's success. That's why success is subjective. Success is not about money. Success is not about celebrity. Success is about, are you doing what makes you happy? Okay, I promise you, Nurse Kelly, I know some millionaire comedians, millionaires in this entertainment business who would trade all of that for a peace of mind. Okay, they would trade all of it for true happiness. But if you want to be a comedian, Kelly, then go be a comedian. When you're not doing your nurse thing, go on stage, do some open mics. Hell, if you want to do comedy sketches at the house on your off time, cool. But when you are in that nursing facility, you have to focus on nursing. How could you possibly be the best nurse you could be when you're too busy trying to be Amy Schumer? Listen to some of these jokes she posted on TikTok while in the nursing facility. I'd unplug your vent to charge my cell phone. Me, making sure all my patients sleep all night because they kept me up last night. And she acts like she's putting too many pills in a person's cup. Would you slap a patient for $1 million? If you had your loved one in this nursing facility, would this make you comfortable seeing a nurse act like that? If you were a patient in this facility, would you be comfortable seeing your nurse act like that? My point, Kelly, is why? Don't answer that. I know why, because nowadays money isn't the root of all evil. Attention is, so much so that people will mess up their money for said attention. Case in point, Kelly Morris. You got suspended from your job as a nurse because you want to get your SNL on and do comedy sketches, and you have the nerve to blame this on cancel culture? Kelly, you work at a nursing facility. Behavior like this gets you fired. There's no cancel culture in this. There's no cancel culture in that nursing facility, but it is termination culture. If they don't like your behavior, if they don't like your performance, they can fire you or, in your case, suspend you. Cancel culture has nothing to do with that. You're a nurse working at a nursing facility talking about harming patients. You don't see how that could rub the powers that be that you work for the wrong way? See, we scream cancel culture when it's just about accountability. Okay, you got suspended because the entity you work for is holding you accountable. Thank God you didn't get fired, but during this suspension, if I'm this nursing facility, I'm looking at you like, she don't get it. She's blaming this on cancel culture. She started a second account on TikTok called Bubblegum Kells with two Z's with the caption, "When trolls get you banned." Like, I can't make a second account. See, she's still performing. Don't know when to stop. Trolls didn't get you banned from TikTok, Kelly. You did. Nobody's trolling you. Nobody trolled you. People are upset on how they see you treating patients that are in the facility or are pretending to treat patients, okay? Number one, they don't know you playing. And number two, they don't care that you playing because why are you playing? Nobody wants to see you joking about giving patients too many pills, lying about vital signs, or acting as though you, you know, want a patient to die. Okay, like, come on, Kelly. All right, she has a GoFundMe, and the page is titled, "TikTok Got Me Fired, So Feed My Kids," with a goal of $20,000. So far, she has raised $60. All right, $60, that is. And that's $1 too many, if you ask me. Once again, Kelly, TikTok didn't get you fired. You did. If you want to be talent, go be talent. If you want to be a comedian, go be a comedian. If you're going to be a nurse, be the best nurse you can be. But you for sure can't do both at the same damn time. Please let North Carolina's own the Hamiltones give North Carolina's Kelly Morris the sweet sounds of the Hamiltones.
You are the donkey of the day. You are the donkey of the day. Yeehaw!
TikTok got me fired, so feed my kids. Your kids can't eat that attention, can they? Your kids can't eat those likes, can they? Your kids can't eat those little floating hearts. Is that TikTok or that's another platform? What platform? What platform does
it's
it look
Instagram.
Instagram Live.
Oh, that's Instagram.
Instagram Live.
Okay, whatever. Same difference.
Donkey of the Day is brought to you by the Law Office of Michael S. Lamonsoff. Don't be a donkey. Dial #250 on your cell and say the bull if you've been hurt in a construction accident. That's #250 from your cell and say the bull.